Dad, what are you burning?
It's wood, Irma. There's nothing wrong with that.
Well, you must be doing something wrong.
What's wrong with burning wood?
The Wastebusters got to hear about this.
Hey, Lloyd. What are we going to investigate today?
Yeah, dude, what's up with the wood?
Smoke!
Wood is a locally produced, renewable natural resource.
But people who choose to burn wood should know that it contributes to air pollution, and it can waste money.
That's why we should find out how to burn wood cleaner and more efficiently.
In many states, smoke from burning wood is a growing problem. Today on Wastebusters, Lloyd, Dave, and Shelley will test two wood-burning myths.
Okay, let's learn how to burn.
It doesn't matter what you burn the wood in, does it?
It certainly does, Dave. Today's EPA-certified stoves and fireplace inserts use a third less wood and burn 70% cleaner.
How could that be true?
We need to talk to some experts.
Hi, Wastebusters.
Hi.
Wood smoke is made up of a complex mixture of gases and fine particles. The smoke enters your lungs and can cause serious health problems. It's associated with asthma, chronic heart and lung diseases, and even cancer.
Oh, that's awful.
Despite the fact that some like the smell, I think everyone knows that smoke is bad for you. But how much smoke can a wood stove produce?
An old stove could emit as much pollution as 7 diesel buses, Dave.
We need to find out more about these new stoves.
Hello, Wastebusters.
Hi.
It burns me up that people don't realize that smoke is unburned fuel.
You mean smoke is waste?
Yes, it is. The new EPA-certified stoves have a heavily insulated firebox, which allows for a hotter fire, burning the wood more completely. The stoves also use a secondary combustion area, which burns the gases and soot particles, making the stove even more efficient.
More burn for your buck!
That all sounds good, but let's put one of these EPA-certified stoves to the test.
I'm glad to see you're thinking for a change, Dave.
Great!
Old versus new. Let's watch while the Wastebusters put these stoves to the test. Lloyd, Dave, and Shelley start with an equal amount of firewood.
3, 2, 1.
Then they time how long before the wood runs out while measuring the emissions.
We're out.
Not me.
Let's compare the results. Shelley's EPA-certified stove burned a third less wood and produced 70% less particle pollution. Shelley wins! It does matter what you burn wood in. In Connecticut alone, residential wood burning creates over 8,500 tons of emissions per year. By installing an EPA-certified stove, you could cut air pollution up to 70%, making it healthier for you and your family to breathe.
Aww. Hey, Wastebusters. Here's the wood you asked for.
Is this the same wood you were burning this morning?
Yep, I cut it myself.
The moisture content seems really high. How long have you been drying it for?
A month or two.
Ned, you need to dry wood for at least 6 months for it to be seasoned properly.
What difference does that make? With one of these EPA-certified stoves, it doesn't matter what you burn.
That's incorrect, Dave. Using unseasoned or green wood is like throwing water onto your fire. Burning seasoned wood cuts your wood consumption up to 30% and significantly reduces the amount of smoke.
Yeah. Somebody was smoking up my neighborhood this morning. Let's prove it.
unseasoned wood versus seasoned wood in EPA-certified stoves. Let's watch while the Wastebusters smoke out this myth.
Light them.
Lloyd and Dave burn unseasoned wood in their new EPA-certified stove, while Ned and Shelley burn seasoned wood in theirs.
Ned! You should never burn trash. It creates toxic air pollutants.
Time.
Let's check out the results. Lloyd and Dave's unseasoned wood took longer to get started, created more smoke, and produced less heat. Ned wins! Using seasoned wood saves time and money. Burning seasoned wood saves you money and reduces pollution. Dry firewood for at least 6 months and get it from a local source. Properly seasoned wood has cracks in the end grain and sounds hollow when struck. Thanks to Dave, Shelley, and Lloyd, these wood-burning myths have been busted.
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 Definitely busted.
Oh, I can finally breathe out here again. Did you get rid of your wood stove, Ned?
Well, yes and no.
What do you mean?
Well, I actually just replaced my old wood stove with a new super efficient model. And now I make sure any wood I'm burning has been seasoned for at least 6 months.
I told you you were doing something wrong.
And Irma, with all the time I'm saving not having to chop as much wood, I've decided to enjoy the fresh air too.
For more wood-burning tips, visit the Department of Environmental Protection website at www.ct.gov/DEP/air. Thanks for watching, Wastebusters!